a 30-year-old young male with no significant past history who presented with complaints of recurrent episodes of abdominal pain of 6 months duration. He had an ultrasound done outside which revealed an aneurysm of superior mesenteric artery. However, we got a CT done and rather than a superior mesenteric artery aneurysm, there was a splenic artery aneurysm which was arising aneurysmally anomalously from the SMA. This was the diagram and this was the SMA origin. Just 20 mm after the origin of this superior mesenteric artery, there was a short stump from where splenic artery was arising, and just at its origin, there was a large aneurysm of the size of 32 into 26 mm, and it was distally as the splenic artery. There was no focal arterial disruption, perivascular inflammation, or irregular aneurysmal wall, so possibilities of pseudaneurysm were ruled out. We got a detailed workup done for pancreatitis, vasculitis, collagen vascular disease, portal hypertension, and infection, all were negative. There was no history of any trauma. Usually, splenic artery arises from the celiac trunk, but in this case it was arising from the superior mesenteric artery. These were the senior loops. It was clearly arising from the SMA rather than from the celiac trunk. We had certain treatment options in mind. Obviously surgery would have been the gold standard, but we thought why not do an endovascular procedure, and there were certain endovascular procedures in our mind. One was, mostly people what they do is, the principle behind treatment is we have to trap the aneurysm distally as well as proximally, and this has to be done at the exit site and at the entry site. So one option was we could put the coils distally just at this portion and another coil just at the entry of this aneurysm, but this was not possible because had we tried putting a coil here, it could have embolized into the SMA distally and caused intestinal ischemia, so that was not a possibility. Secondly, for the same reason we did not attempt the obliteration of aneurysmal sac, because there was also a possibility of embolization of this device or gel form into the distally into the SMA. So thirdly, we thought that why not put a coil or a plug just at the exit site of this aneurysm and then block the entry site by placing a stent across the SMA, which will obliterate the entry site of this splenic artery. So in view of short stump and a disparity in the proximal and the distal segments of the aneurysm, we thought we would put a coil at the exit end and trap the entry end with a stent across SMA. Wiring was extremely difficult because we tried through the femoral approach, we tried through this brachial approach, but every time wire was just revolving in this sac. It was not going through the into the distal part. Ultimately, we could enter using a microcatheter playing, and finally we could deploy the smaller micro coils. We use 4 mm coil, we use 6 mm coil, we use 7 mm coil. They were getting stuck in this proximal part just at the exit site, but within a minute or two they were getting distally embolized. So at this moment we abandoned the procedure for two reasons. We did not have the larger coil. Secondly, the problem was we thought this was our first experience. We thought we might cause a splenic infarction, so we abandoned the procedure. We waited for another 1 month. There was no evidence of any infarction. Patient did not have any symptoms. He did not have any. There was no splenic abscess or any infection was noted. So we reattempted this procedure. This time we were well prepared. We used a Simis catheter, and now we could deploy larger coils. We used 20 mm coils this time, 20 mm into 50 cm, and we were able to deploy two coils, one in the middle portion, and one got stuck just at the exit site. So effectively, it trapped the aneurysm distally. This is the after putting a coil at the distal end, there was no flow in the distal end, in the distal splenic artery, through this. And after that, we placed a stent across the SMA, obliterating the entry site of this aneurysm. So this was the final angiogram, and you can clearly see there was no flow across this aneurysm. And we got a CT done after 1 year follow-up. Patient was asymptomatic. We got a CT done. This was the pre-picture, and the second one is a post-picture. You can see that there is hardly, the aneurysm is totally shrunken. As compared to this, this is totally shrunken in this. And now we have got a 2 years follow-up. Patient is doing absolutely fine. There have been no symptoms. So concluding remarks are, splenic artery aneurysms are the most common visceral aneurysms, but usually splenic artery arises from the celiac trunk. In our case, it was rare presentation. It was anomalously arising from the SMA. With an aneurysm, it is very rarely reported. Only 30 cases have been reported in the literature so far. Most of them have been managed surgically, and this was one of the rare cases we have been able to manage it through endovascular approach.